you for joining us tonight. It is a late night at the state capitol as lawmakers are set to pass a set of GOP bills that would strip incoming Democrats of their powers.
But it's still unclear whether that will actually happen. Rose Schmidt spent the day at the state capitol, and she joins us live there with the very latest. Rose?
That's right. It's been a night filled with waiting and delays. The state assembly was originally scheduled to start on the floor at 1 p.m. today, but now 9 hours later, that still has yet to happen. They still have yet to start, but we are told that it might happen soon. It's still unclear tonight whether or not Republicans in the two houses have struck a deal yet. The Senate passed a transportation measure, one out of three of these lame duck session bills, but the fate of a bill that would weaken the powers of Tony Evers and Josh Kaul is still unclear. In a pair of joint news conferences this afternoon, Democrats argued the Republicans are ignoring the results of the midterm elections, while GOP leaders say they won't let Tony Evers' quote liberal agenda take them backward.
We did have an election. Whether everyone here likes it or not, I respect the fact that Tony Evers is the governor and he's going to be starting on January 7th, but he's not the governor today.
The actions that are taken today that are before us will override the will of the people, which were decided on November 6th of this year with the statewide election of Governor Tony Evers and Attorney General Josh Kaul.
Democrats have said they will consider legal action if these proposals are passed, to which Speaker Voss says that that is within their power to do so. Voss also told us earlier that he is confident that all three of these bills will pass the full legislature tonight, but with the assembly still yet to start and the Senate in recess for several hours tonight, we could be here into the wee hours of the morning.
We appreciate Rose's long hours. Rose Schmidt live at the Capitol tonight. Rose, thank you.